So let's move on now to what happened earlier today at the APC Secretariat in Abuja last week. A group led by Alhaji Kawu Baraje, one of those who led the new PDP bloc in the, that moved into the APC at that time, are also worried that they are marginalized and they are being sidetracked in the party. But today, another group from that same bloc are saying that is not correct. Earlier today, they also had a press conference. That means even in the MPDP, there is a crack. Let's get to the conversation. Joining us from our Abuja studio is a member of the House of Representatives and one of the group who appeared at the APC Secretariat earlier today, Honorable Abdulmumin Jibrin, a member of the House of Representatives from Kano State representing the APC there. Many thanks for joining us, Honorable Jibrin. It's been a long time we had you since your trouble about suspension and you're coming back into the House. So there is another trouble brewing, isn't it? Especially with this issue of the new PDP bloc in the APC. Is it looking like an implosion in your party?
Well, it is not an implosion, but the only thing is that most of us are left in shock. We're very surprised, very embarrassed, because some of us that played a very important role in the formation of the new defunct new PDP, because it's not in existence. We are all surprised when we saw Kawu Baraje going to the party secretariat to submit the letter. And the first thing we, most of us did, was to start asking our colleagues, our then colleagues, are you aware, are you aware, are you aware? And everybody says he's not aware about the letter. Most of us are not even aware that the letter went. So it's quite curious. No meeting was held. The last meeting we held was in 2014, 2015, no meeting, 16, no meeting, 17, no meeting, because we've merged into the broader APC. And so it's shocking that someone will go without consultation, without any resolution of any meeting of the defunct NPDP, and to say that we have been marginalized. Another thing to take note of is that one of the persons that signed the letter, Oyinlola, and even left the party a couple of days before the letter was delivered. So somebody who is not even in the party is asking the party to come and address grievances. And so we thought of it, as you've just mentioned, I've been out of maybe perhaps taking a bit of a sabbatical, but because of this, I felt personally pained, and I thought it's important for one to speak out at this point. Now, majorly, they raised issues of marginalization. Marginalization in government, marginalization by the party, and witch hunt. Now, when you look at the facts, and all these are contained in the letter we submitted to the party, when you look at all the facts, it is not true. It's a misrepresentation. When you take the government, for instance, the government, the executive does not operate in isolation. When you talk about the government, you're talking about the executive, and of course, even the legislature. So there's a balance of power. The CPC, which was led by Muhammadu Buhari, got the president. The ACN, which was led by Asiwaju Bola Tinubu, got the vice president. Now, deliberately or not, the Senate president and the speaker combined together went to the defunct new PDP. So, and when you look at the whole of these positions, all of them comes with a lot of patronage, massive instrument of reward. As much as the president can make appointments, the Senate President makes appointment, the Speaker makes appointment between the Senate President and, of course, the Speaker. They've dished out about 200 appointments, including committee chairman. And because I was part of the system at then, and most of us in the defunct new PDP were part of it, no day did we consult the President or allocate or
Honorable Jibrin,
help us nominate.
Sorry if I'm a button here. We need to take a crucial break. And when we come back, we'll be asking critical questions to the reactions that we're getting from these different groups who are now talking about marginalization in the party ahead of the 2019 elections, the implications for the APC. That's next on the program. Join us again, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. Earlier today, a former governor of Nasarawa State and member of the defunct New People's Democratic Party in the APC, Senator Abdullah Adamu, and some members of the APC who also belong to that group had come out to say the issues of marginalization has been raised by the Kawu Baraje group of the defunct MPDP bloc in the APC is untrue. They had a press conference earlier today at the party APC office, and we have one of the members of that group talking to us from our Abuja studio, Honorable Abdulmimi Jibrin, who is also a member of the House of Representatives. Thank you so much for talking to us on this one. So with what we are saying now is like a deja vu of some sort. When we hear the new PDP give a press conference like this before 2015 election, shortly afterwards, they moved out, they broke away from the PDP. Do you see an imminent breaking away of some of these people, eminent members of the party, out of the APC?
But who are the people you are talking about? Because as far as we're all concerned, we saw Kawu Baraji on the screen, no any other person. And most of the key members that we got in touch with, all of them seems not to be aware of what Kawu Baraji and a few others went to do. Because when you look at it rationally, I'll be surprised if they have any issue of marginalization. For instance, if you belong to the NPDP group and you eventually emerge as the Senate president, I don't understand how you talk about marginalization or you emerge as the speaker. Now, take a look at all the key members of the defunct new PDP, including myself, and tell me one person that today is not accommodated in this government. The Senate president is there. It's a senator, Senate president, speaker, member of House of Reps, speaker. You pick my former boss, Tambual. He has emerged Governor Sokoto. Abdullahi Ganduje, who was part of the team, he is now governor of Kano State. Senator Goje emerged as a senator. He is the chairman of appropriation, perhaps one of the strongest positions in this country. I was there and I know. So when you are holding all these positions, you can go on and on. Senator Aleru, Senator Bindo that became a governor, all of them. Amechi that became a minister. Mind you, Amechi is the only person who didn't have anything and was accommodated by the president. But every other key member of the defunct new PDP has something holding. And if you look at the accumulation of all these positions that are in the hands of the leaders of the NPDP, it's enough to cater for all the members that moved into the APC from the NPDP. Perhaps the issues of selfishness, greed, etc., within the leaders. And that's the problem that we're faced with.